This video is going to build on the video about major scales. We're going to talk about some other things that we can use to label major scales other than just the name of the scale. So I'm going to go ahead and start by writing out a major scale just for a little bit of review. Let's use a bass clef today. And I think I'd like to use an F major scale. Now I have a couple Fs I could choose from. I could start on this F here, the line that goes through the clef. But if I do that, I'm going to end up having to use a lot of ledger lines because it'll go really high. So I'm actually going to start on this lower F here on the space beneath the last line. I guess it's the first line. Yeah, so the space beneath the lowest line, let's say that. That's an F, so I'm going to start there. That way I don't have to use ledger lines. It just will make it a little bit easier to write out. Remember the pattern? Whole, whole, half. Whole, 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 half. There's my whole, whole, half. I had to use a B flat to get that half step. And there's the rest of my pattern. So I can see that my F major scale has one flat in it. And it's a B flat. Actually, that will always be true, right? Because whenever I start on an F, if I use that pattern, I will always end up with that B flat there. Because the keyboard doesn't change shapes and sizes between times that I look at it, which is super helpful. So there's your F major scale. Okay, so I've labeled it F major, but also I can think about how each note in the scale has a unique property. And as you learn more advanced music theory, you do learn that that's a really important part of how notes behave, is their placement in the scale. So sometimes we like to refer to notes not just by their letter names, but by how they relate to the rest of the scale. So in order to do that, we're going to give them labels that have to do with scale degrees. And I'm going to teach you three different labels for scale degrees, and you should learn all of them because they're all very useful depending on what you need to do with them. So the first labels for scale degrees that I'll teach you is numbers. So we can just number the notes of the scale, like this is the first note of the scale, this is the second note of the scale, and so on. So that's what I'm going to do. Okay, so I've labeled seven scale degrees. So I could say in the F major scale, scale degree 3 is an A. See how that works? Or I could say, what's the fifth scale degree in F major? And you could say C is. And that will always be true because of the pattern. You'll notice a couple things about how I did this. First of all, I wrote it above the staff. So the scale degree label came above the note that I was referring to. That's just kind of a standard practice. It makes it easier to see what you're talking about. So if I ever ask you to label a note on a staff with its scale degree, I would want it above the staff. A second thing that happens is that you use these are called carrots, not like the vegetable carrot, but like a carrot, the little tent looking thing. So if you put carrots above scale degrees to show that that's what you mean when you say them, that way you don't have to write out scale degree every time you want to say something. If you're doing this in writing or if you're putting this on paper somehow, it's actually really useful. There are a lot of numbers that we use in music theory, and so it's important to be able to keep them straight. So remember how we use numbers when we were talking about time signatures and things like that? Well, that's just one of many ways. So you know it's a time signature because you have the two numbers one on top of the other. And so just like that, you know that these are scale degree numbers because they have the carats. So that way it doesn't get confusing when we start talking about other ways to use numbers. Okay, so that's the biggest thing about labeling. One other thing you'll notice is that I didn't label this last note with an 8. That's because this isn't actually a different note. This is the same note that we had at the beginning. So if I'm going to label this F, I'm going to label all Fs the same. So if F is scale degree 1 because it begins the scale, then this F is also scale degree 1. So remember when I was talking about the ability to do more than one octave of a scale? We could continue up and do another F major scale starting here and just keep going. If we did that, it would make sense to start over on scale degree 1 again. So it's that kind of idea. So this means now that any F is a scale degree 1. Any B flat is a scale degree 4. So if I write this, that B flat up there is still scale degree 4, as long as I'm still in the key of F major. So it doesn't have to be the exact same pitch, it just has to be the same note name. So this is really useful when you are looking at a piece of music that has lots of notes and not necessarily in a scalar pattern like this, but you can look at the piece and you can determine what scale degrees the notes are in the piece. So like if I had a piece that's in F major and then I just saw B flat just doing whatever, I would say, oh, I know that B flat is scale degree 4. And so right now that doesn't mean much to you. It's mostly just a label, but eventually you'll learn why that matters and what kinds of things you might be able to do with that. So it's a really important thing to be able to do to pick that out of any kind of pattern of any notes that you see, as long as you know that the piece is in F major, because B flat might not be scale degree 4. Actually, F major is the only key where B flat is scale degree 4. So let's look at another key where B flat is not scale degree 4. I think I'll use a treble clef this time. I'm going to write out a D flat major scale. If you want to quiz yourself, you could pause the video right now. See if you can write one yourself. Get some staff paper. You can print some off if you don't have any. I have some on Blackboard for you. So see if you can write this scale by yourself. And then come back and check and see if you did it right. Okay, so here's my D-flat major scale. Now if I find B-flat in this scale, right here, this is not scale degree 4. What scale degree is it? Well, we just start counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here's scale degree 6 is B-flat. So if I go back to this, depending on where I see this note, what key I'm in, really affects the scale degree. It's very important. So if I'm in F major, it's scale degree 4, and that has a certain types of properties to that. But if I'm in D flat major, it would be scale degree 6, and that has certain types of properties in that instance as well. They would be different. So it's really important that you know what key you're in before you start doing scale degrees at all. Okay, so that's the number method. There's also the names. We have actual names for scale degrees, like words, so I'll go ahead and write those out for you. Okay, so I have these written out for you. It's really important that you memorize these. You'll have to know these for some assessments coming up. So you need to memorize the names and also know how to spell them. That's actually also really important. So I'm going to go ahead and talk about them for a second and give you a little bit of a tip on how to listen or how, well, yeah, not how to listen for them exactly, not yet, but how to remember what they're called. So scale degree one is called the tonic. Scale degree one in every scale is kind of like the most important note. It's the one that makes you feel like you're at rest when you're hearing the scale. That's why we start and end on it. Or maybe it sounds like rest because we start and end on it. That's actually, I'm not really sure about that, but it definitely gives us that sense of being something really stable. So scale degree one is always tonic. So if you say, what's the tonic of D flat major? Well, D flat is. So whatever the scale is called, that's the tonic note or scale degree one. Okay, so I'm going to skip up to dominant, which is scale degree five. Dominant is kind of the second most important note of a scale. So tonic and dominant are the two notes that you end up hearing them, generally hear them the most, and also they're the notes that give you the most stability in your scale. Okay, so scale degree three is kind of like the third most important. So we go up a third, tonic, to mediant, to dominant. So if you think about tonic and dominant being the most important notes, and you think about the one that comes halfway in between those notes, that's your mediant, like a medium or like middle sort of, right? Or like, no, I'm thinking like median, like in the road, you know, like we have like one lane of traffic going one way and then the other lane coming at you, and in the middle you have a median. So it's that kind of idea, this median. Okay, supertonic is called that because it's one above tonic. So if you think of super, the prefix super meaning above or something like that, or like higher. So it's tonic, then supertonic. And you have dominant and you have subdominant, which is one lower than dominant. And then you have submediant, and this one feels weird because it's so far removed from mediant. But if you think about scale degree one going up to three, so like one, two notes up, is a mediant. But if you go down the same amount from one, like there, you get submediant. So it's mediant is like saying, this is what I am above tonic, and submediant is like that same interval, that same number of pitches down from tonic. And leading tone is called a leading tone because of its special properties. Remember that there's only a half step between scale degree 7 and scale degree 1 again. So when we talk about the leading tone, it's because of that half step. Scale degree 7 really, really wants to move up to scale degree 1. And I'll do a listening video at some point to show you kind of what I mean by that. But because there's only a half step, it's almost like a magnet. Like the closer notes are together, the more they want to pull into each other. So this, we call this the leading tone because it leads to tonic. Like it leads up. Okay, so that's kind of how I like to remember the names. But at some point you do just have to memorize them. But that's how I remember if I get them mixed up. That's kind of what I used to memorize. So that's the second way to label scale degrees. And the third way is by solfege. Solfege is another label for scale degrees. The names are much shorter, and you often will use solfege when you sing. So you may have learned this in high school, like if you're in choir or even just in music class, you might have learned solfege. And if you end up taking ear training classes, say singing in ear training classes, you will sing on solfege. So I'm going to teach you that now so that when you get there, you'll be ready and it won't be an extra thing you have to learn then, since we're doing scales anyway. So I'm going to go ahead and label this D flat major scale up here. I'm going to label this with solfege. Okay, and these syllables come from Latin. So all of the I's sound like E, and all of the E's sound like A. So if I were to pronounce this, I would say do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. It's kind of hard to tell what that is, isn't it? That's S-O-L. All right, so we've got. Again, starting on scale degree 1. Scale degree 1 is Do. Scale degree 2 is Re. Scale degree 3 is Mi. Scale degree 4 is Fa. Scale degree 5 is Sol. Scale degree 6 is La. Scale degree 7 is Ti. And then back to scale degree 1, which is Do. So sometimes people use these terms interchangeably. Like they might say, oh, look at the tonic pitch. Or, oh, look, it's Do. Or did you hear scale degree 1 there? And that all means D flat if you're in the key of D flat major. So there are different times when these different labels are useful, but it's good for you now to know what all of them are, to be able to say them and spell them correctly so that you can have conversations with other people that know about music and be able to communicate how things are working in any piece that you're playing. So make sure that you learn what these are and be able to switch between them if necessary. One thing that's interesting, scale degrees and almost all of the, generally the terms as well, remain the same whether you're in a major scale or a minor scale, which we'll talk about in about a week. But solfege definitely changes when you go from major to minor scales. Not all of them, but some of them do. So we'll talk about how that works, and it's interesting to know that these are the labels for the major scale, but there are a few variants when we go into minor scales. So there won't be any variant to the numbers. Those are always exactly the same because you're just counting. You're not really concerned about the pattern, but solfege kind of tells you a little bit about the pattern. So as we continue on, we'll continue talking about how that works. For now, the only thing I want you to note with solfege is that anytime you have an E vowel sound, like here, mi, and here, T, anytime you have that, that's where the half step exists in the scale. So mi up to fa and T up to do. So that's something that's really interesting and can help you remember where the half step is if you memorize the solfege pattern. All right, that's all I have for today. If you need to watch this one again, go for it. If you need to go back and watch the major scales video again, go for it. Whatever you need. And as always, I'm here for questions to help you. And I hope you have a great day.